Alright, so now we're playing a different Rich Estelle net. We went 4-1 there, and I punted that matchup. So I should have played that one better. Think that this had to play. I was like, oh, just dies to removals, dies to everything. But I was wrong. Probably just gonna daze the first play. Okay, we're playing against lands. Whoa. I don't really understand what's going on. That's being stage lands, I diamond. Alright, well now we get to at least check out what's going on. My opponent has the combo next turn, so I need to find a wasteland. I'm trying to find a wasteland right now. If I don't find a wasteland, I'm in a lot of trouble. So if I find a wasteland, I'm good. But if I don't, I'm probably not gonna win. We can see a lot of cards here. Oh, that's not good. Looks like we didn't find it. I can like, we're just like super dead. I can play Delver and flip it and block, but like that's not gonna win us the game. So I guess I should have forced this, it'll give me more time. And I'm not gonna make my opponent do it while I'm streaming here. That's unfortunate. Just didn't find it. So let's get Diabolic Edicts in. I could bring in a card like Surgical Extraction. Because they have Shallow Grave, so they also seem like a reanimator deck. I probably can cut my Lightning Bolts. Cut my Cold Bounce Command, cut my Dismember. And maybe like a Cabal Therapy package is fine. We're playing against like combo deck. Try something like this. Yeah, let's give this a try. Tough one to mess with. Alright, we will keep this. We've got interaction for the graveyard, but we don't really have interaction for 2020 yet. So that's what we'll be digging for with this brainstorm. But if we can get past the 2020 one time, we should be able to deal with everything else pretty fine. Silent Gravestone. Okay, so that's another reason to leave in good reason to leave in cards like Abrade or Colodon's Commander for sideboard. Okay. So let's go fetch. I guess I didn't have to do that. That was a mistake. I should have like left it, used this for mana, and then only crack my fetch land if I have to. Yeah, that was stupid. That was just poor sequencing on my part. Okay, scrub land. Lotus Petal. Holy shanties, what is going on here? I should have attacked because that's right.
Exile, can't be the target of spells or abilities.
Yeah, because I can't even do that. I should have attacked. I will reveal this probe. Yeah, that was all stupid on my part. I missed out on a point of damage. I haven't played against this card very much. 1, 2, 3, 4, 7. All right, well, we're gonna be able to daze a Gristlebrand. Yeah, that was my fault there. This. Get this Pyromancer down because it's a clock. Actually, how, they're gonna be able to cast the Gristlebrand because of this Lion's Eye Diamond. I keep forgetting to attack with this Deathrite Chomp. I just keep forgetting that, like, I can't use this. Yeah, because they cracked the Lion's Eye Diamond for mana. I don't understand why else they're running everything out here. They know that was on top, or they just top decked that probably. So I guess I've got, I know my top cards are fetch land. So I can't even, like, they can just draw a million cards, it doesn't really matter. Yeah, I'll just go next game here. Yeah, I mean, that was kind of cool. I thought to myself, like, oh, they're casting the Gristlebrand. And I was like, nope, they're not. You live and learn. That was an odd... I don't know. I've never seen a deck like that before. And I played poorly because I haven't seen... because I hadn't seen that deck before, so like I didn't play very well against that artifact. So that was my fault. It was a Dark Depths deck that also played a Reanimator package in it. And they hosed me in game 2 when I removed my artifact hate. Like it was like an LED deck that cheated mana to make 20/20s, or just dump things in the graveyard and reanimate it. I just played poorly.
Oh, give me 1 second.
Yeah, and then it played... I played poorly against that Silent Graphstone artifact. Which is just from, like, not knowing... Not playing against it enough, not really understanding exactly. You live and you learn. Something that if I was going to take, if I was going to take this, well, like I see in a big turn or something like that, I have to pay attention just because, like, to know what's going on. But I just doing that. Is there going to have foil to any nemesis? Oh, here we go. How's that?
Is that a little better?
I just turned it off on my OBS. God, if only I had a Death Shadow to play on one, I'm gonna keep this. If I hit a land, I'm good. Played my opponent again. Oh, I played them earlier. Played against Elves. Now I have an idea of what's going on at least. Alright, there we go. So, how much damage? Anywhere else? What's a P? I don't want to lose to like mediocre beats, which is my only issue. Play Llanowar Elves. I guess next turn I'll try to kill the Llanowar Elves. But for now, I'm just gonna go get a Valk and then play a Delver. I'm assuming they're playing together. Hope we have a way to like limit this. I want this flip to lightning bolt. Daze is also pretty good. So let's start looking for removal. Okay, so they have a glimpse. Just get it now. Okay. Oh, that's frustrating. Alright, I mean, I guess it would have happened anyways, but let's just attack, play the Pyromancer. At least the Pyromancer is going to stop the beatdowns. I'm going to be pretty aggressive with my counter magic because I just want to end the game. And the counter magic makes offense. My opponent might just play like a Nettle Sentinel in order to just stabilize the board a little bit. And they know I have this daze. I prefer not to daze in order to like maybe I'll ponder in. Career Ranger. Now what does that one do? Return a forest you control to its owner's hand. Untap target creature. So this basically gives them more mana. Symbiote Visionary. But like this card is very important, very good. Because you get to untap target creatures, so they make a mana. This basically makes them like 3 mana. Like I almost want to force this. Because this makes them 2 more mana this turn. And then my daze isn't going to be any good. I think I have to force this. And just hope they didn't hit another land. this out of here. I mean, now we're just kind of going all in. I think we're cracking him for 7. Best draw Lightning Bolt. Force isn't bad. Because I don't think they can glimpse me next. I mean, he could glimpse me next turn, I assume. If we draw a blue card next turn, then we feel pretty good about the spot. Right, so they're just going to glimpse me right here. Oh, they drew another Quirion Ranger. That's probably gonna kill me. So they make their land drop. They play the Heritage Druid. Make 3 more mana. Yeah, that's probably just gonna get me here. What are you saying no to, Tyler? So why not force the elf with the information that I have known, knowing that the elf makes 2 mana for them and allows them to dump their hand and make it so my daze isn't very good? Like, they basically turn my daze off, right? If I let that resolve. And then they begin to slowly do, like, load up the mediocre beats, you know what I mean? I don't really want to sit through this. And I was like, and I don't know the deck well enough to know if my opponent, with Pyro out, they won't attack your tokens. Why do you suck? I don't know. But also I was thinking that, all right, yeah, we're just gonna skip this up here. I don't need to play this game any longer. Ugh. I don't know. Cause like, so I think I want everything that we think. So if I know my opponent has 6 spells in their hand when they cast the Quirion Ranger, and only 1 land. So, if I let my opponent, just start going nuts, then they basically can just start casting all their stuff and putting their synergies together if I don't just force that and hope that they don't play another creature, or hope they don't have another land, or another Quirion Ranger, which they end up having a Quirion Ranger. But I don't think with the information that I knew that they could go off without a Quirion Ranger or another land. I guess another land gives them a Green Sun Zenith too. Oh, we totally want Last Hope, Evan, we totally won Last Hope. I love Last Hope against this deck. Games get much slower after sideboard, and this just picks off so many of their like chaff creatures that aren't that important. I think about what I want to board out. Gurmag Angler is probably not great. It just gets chunked for days. Last Hope, it's not too, things slow down after sideboard. Like they bring in a bunch of Abrupt Decays. Right, the games just kind of slow down. You'd play therapy. I guess therapy is also decent because their deck is a bunch of one ofs or a bunch of four ofs. I don't know what to cut though. I don't want Angler. I don't think I want Command. Pierce is like okay, but I have plenty of answers to that. I have 8 answers to that on the play. Maybe I'll have to bring some in on the draw. So maybe sideboard a little differently on the draw. I'm gonna go with this. Okay. On the draw, I'm gonna bring the therapies in, but I'm gonna be probably cutting my gazes. I think it's a deck that's just full of mana. Would like to play first. So I have land. I have land, fetch land, brainstorm. A way to interact early in a redraw. I'm gonna keep this. It's not great, but hopefully this brainstorm digs me out of a lot of issues. Here, I like keeping hands. I like keeping a lot of sevens where I have brainstorm, because like if I have brainstorm plus land, fetch land, then, how do I say this? Then the brainstorms are better because you have more cards. So Glimpse, Eldritch Knight, that's right, I'm okay. Okay. So I don't want to fetch, I'm probably dazing, and I'm okay. Or dazing this Death Ray Shaman. So let's play this and go. I think it's gonna be a slow game, so I'm not gonna brainstorm here. I'm just gonna pay a mana and pick this up, then replay the land next turn. Though I'm actually gonna brainstorm, because if I can hit a Deathrite Shaman, then that's gonna like bait out this decay. Yeah. Let's not be crazy. Okay, so let's put a wheel shuffle back a land. And there's not even any guarantee that they can play the decay anyways. Now this death rate's gone. It's underground sea. And then we'll get this Liliana down next turn and start picking things off. The nice thing that I really like, okay, so now they're gonna be able to pick this. Which I assume they're going to do now. I don't think it should let me untap with the shaman. But I just put this in. Okay. So I know they have a glimpse. And one other card. So the problem is that this decay is just going to take out my Liliana if I play it and tick up on this. So I think I'm just going to brainstorm to start. That's not bad. The problem is, do I think they have enough gas to go off with a glimpse? And the answer is like probably. Like I probably have to ponder. I can't just go double Delver. Especially when there's no guarantee that they're gonna flip. We get a Valk. Yeah. Shuffle this. Pay blue. Get this Delver down. So you think I should have slammed the Liliana, Tyler? Alright, we got a little value glimpse going on here. Okay, so there's Deathrite Shaman. I'm just gonna Then I play Cradle. Cradle taps for two. My Green Sun. Okay, so that. Oh, Wirewood Symbiote. Turn an elf you control what's on their hand. Untap target creature. Okay, so I'm going to smoke this Wirewood Symbiote with my Liliana. That's actually a pretty good draw. No, Delrin gets some pressure. Play Liliana, we can Kissel Ring. Get rid of the Wirewood. Yeah. Okay. So let's make black. Tick on this, waste this. Now they have to use like their entire turn in order to kill this Liliana with this Abrupt Decay. Wasteland was actually a pretty sick draw. Then we're just gonna hold back the Delver and hopefully our Delver flips. Gotta get rid of it. This deck's hard to play against. This deck's one of the harder decks to play against. I notice. Because it's just like, there's just a lot going on. There's a lot of moving parts. There's a lot of creatures that work together. Yeah, we're just gonna let that happen. And then make my opponent decay this. Not trading my Delver for this Elvish Visionary. Okay, they eat my Wasteland. Are they gonna natural order me? No. Championing an elf. Alright. Guess I should have blocked that thing. That's not bad. It's not good, but at least like make so they can't decay my they can't decay this Liliana. Yeah, this thing's gonna be a problem. I've got Dismember in my deck, but I think that's the only answer I have to this. So I need these Delvers to flip. Creature activate this ability. Okay, so now, like, they go eat a mana or make a mana with Deathrite Shaman. I fight them on it. They untap this. So I should have just let this happen and eaten a. But then they would have just untapped it in any ways. Yeah, this is a good draw. I need my Delvers to flip. If I can flip both of these Delvers, it's like a lightning bolt, especially kill this Shaman, then I'll be in good shape, I think. But that's a must happen. I'm not even in good shape. I'm just in like marginal shape. So show me a lightning bolt. And Pyromancer. My Delvers aren't flipping. That could have been a spell. All right, I'm gonna play my land out because I could draw Marsh Casualties, and I would like to do it for two if I do. But I'm probably in trouble now. Well, I guess if I eat this now, it keeps him off natural order. I don't want to get natural ordered. But he can just make a wolf also. One. No, it doesn't even keep him off natural order because he gets to make a land drop. Yeah. That was not good. So he's black. It's going to decay something. All right. We're going to take about one more draw step. Yeah, like, I struggle against this deck here. Because I'm just not familiar with what exactly is going on. Because there's just so many moving parts. Like, when I played against... we just got to take this. When I played against Andrew Jessup at the SCG, when I was playing against him, and he played this, like, I felt very confused. So flip this to Lightning Bolt, and, like, maybe we have a game. All right. Okay, so how do I win? I kill this, trade with this, and then start gaining life with Deathrite Shaman. Yeah, you're so far away from everything. How is the new job? I can't do anything else. You're at work right now. Jeez, that's late. But like, if I block the big guy, come back, they're still Deathrite Shamaning me, right? Like, at least if I trade here, I can start gaining life with the Deathrite Shaman. What if I attack for 6, my opponent attacks for 7, 5, I have to chump block this. And then I can hope to maybe draw something to get in the way of this again. So maybe my best line of play is to attack, chump, nug them, draw. I take 3, go to 3. Give it to her to respond. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Yeah, I don't think I win this game going much longer. So, like, maybe I let them brick and this doesn't untap, and then I eat, and then I find a blocker for this. Yeah, I think we're just gonna attack, block. We're just gonna try to end this game. Oh no, because this lets him untap target creature. So this can attack no matter what. So that basically just, because he goes like, tap, make a wolf, right, untap this, yeah. See, again, like, this is just the mistake that I'm making here. Nice. All right. All right, that's bad. That was not good. Alright. Nug you. I can fetch one more black source. Alright, it got us. Alright, let's go on to game 3. And I'm sure, like, I played that poorly. You know, like, I'm very sure that I just didn't know... what exactly was going on to the best there. Well, no, I was trying, when I made my, I guess I should have like audibled in when they played the choke, maybe, but my whole line of play was like, which was wrong anyways, because I didn't know how the Quirion Ranger worked, because the Quirion Ranger, you could have just done it anyways. So like, because my whole idea, that was just a bad key. Yeah, that would have been it. We're gonna look at any part of the game, that would be it. What did I do? I kept Brainstorm, Deathrite Shaman, Liliana, land, 4 fetch lands. So I basically needed my Brainstorm to be nuts in order to be at parity. Oh, I had a spell pierce, right? Yeah, maybe I should have mulliganed. I probably should have mulliganed that one. I hate mulliganing with these cantrip decks. Yeah, I mean, you're gonna keep this, right? 3 redraws. Good protection. Yeah. Didn't bring him therapies. This is a nice Hearthstone hand. Alright, so we're playing the mirror. Which I'm kind of already at a little bit of a disadvantage, because I'm going down to like 4 life. God, I need a Death Shadow. I think there's so many of the cards that overlap that without seeing, like this hand could easily, like, well, Grixis Delver played all these cards, right? Like all these Delver decks play so many. All right, come on. Come on, land. Chose not to shuffle. So I'm at 8. And maybe this is my fault. Like, and maybe I'm just like, maybe the biggest thing that I have to learn is to like just keep better hands. But like, all the cards in my deck functionally do the same thing. Shaman, okay. So you have double bolt that I know of. We got 1 draw step here. Alright, we're good here. Okay, so in the mirror, I want to break. So I'm on the play, so I want my dazes. I don't want my forces. I want my braids, my pyroblasts. My Liliana, my Marsh Casualties. I don't really like Spell Pierce because like so many of the cards that are really impactful are creatures. I think the cards that I'm bringing in are like just more removal, which is much better. I'd like to find room for some therapies, not therapies, for Edicts, just as a way to deal. I just have a couple outs of True Name Nemesis, but I don't know what to move around. Over here. Yeah. No, I'm not bringing in therapy. I want to affect the board in these mirrors. I want to play to the board. I would like to find room for these edicts. But I don't really know what to cut. I want my dazes. I want command, true name, bolt, pyroblast. I could shave like a probe. I don't hate shaving a probe. Or something that actually does something. Probe's only really good when your pyromancer going. Over a brain. I can see that. Yeah, I can see that. A braid only kills like a braid just like the fifth lightning bolt. Yeah, what would I cut though? And I think what I hate about Flusterstorms a lot of the times is after sideboard in these Delvermeers is that the cards that matter the most are like creatures and planeswalkers. Like the Liliana of the Last Hopes and like the True Name Nemesises. And I get that like you fight over those cards and the counter magic helps the most. But like maybe then that's why I like I think I've been gravitating more towards like the stifle versions of the deck because they play on a lower level. Yeah, my hand's very good. Like we're just gonna daze their first thing and then wasteland them. But we could get dazed back. We can get dazed back, which is kind of annoying. It's one of the awkward things in these mirrors is that like the person on the draw does better with days, even though I don't think they're supposed to have days in their deck. Get out of my face. I have Aatrop, yeah. I lost to Tez. That was the only deck that I lost to in the last one here. Alright, we're gonna have ourselves a little Mexican standoff here. I think I'm just gonna do this so that like it makes this wasteland awkward and it like might incentivize my opponent to not wasteland me. Let him wasteland, you play a DRS. Yeah, I guess he's not gonna waste me. Yeah, I just scoop it up there. We've had two great games. Okay, so on the draw I like sideboard a lot differently. I've noticed. Like, I don't want these dazes. And I tend to want, like, a couple of these Force of Wills. And something, like, a little bit more removal in order to just make sure that I don't get run out of the gym. Like, I like this Abrade on the draw. There's so many micro decisions that are so difficult. That's why I really like... I like the Stifle version, the one that I just streamed. Because it plays the game on smaller on some of those. I do think you want force in these mirrors in the draw. I don't think you want four of them. No, because like I think the things that matter are like the creatures. I don't want all of them. And like I'll bring in these, but I haven't played very much of it, but I've found that I've wanted these forces on the draw. Zero decisions. Yeah, I guess that makes sense. I like the forces on the draw when I don't have when I don't have whatever it is. Dazes. Yeah, but like, first of all, you have to like draw them, and they have to not have like. Sometimes you just need the card that forces through those things, that forces through these threats and these cards, especially when you're on the draw and you don't have the tempo. So that's why I like just two of these on the draw here. Which are dazes. Yeah, that makes sense. I guess my hand, my deck is pretty red. So I do want to work this. This is probably too slow on the draw. I mean, I'll bring in some of these. We'll try some of these. But I do want, and I've seen many people playing against me, have forces when they're on the draw. Just because you need something to be able to break serve. Or to be able to like force through your thing. But like, these matchups I don't think are very grindy. I think these matchups come to like landing an angler or landing a true name while in the same turn being able to throw the tempo back by protecting it. Like, I think that's what these come down to more often than not. It's like who pushes the thing through and then tempo out tempos the other person with like an advantage. And I think the best way to do that on the draw is to have a force in your deck. That's what I've seen them playing it, and that's what I've seen the people have been doing against me. Yeah, I'm not playing Baleful Strix. I don't understand why that's relevant. This hand's not that great, but I have an answer to Deathrite Shaman, a threat, a redraw, and like something that I need just in, if I need just in case. So I don't really want a mulligan here. None of the Grixis lists are playing Strix. Evan. Not Evan. Yeah, no, not Evan, sorry. None of them are. No, they're not. I'm gonna dismember a Deathrite Shaman in one. It's probably like going to wind up bad, but like I'm probably gonna therapy me? Is that what's happening here? Yeah, like The Delver, you just have better grindy cards that work towards killing your opponent. A rough draw. So I guess I can see how this is gonna work. The question is, am I gonna force, if they daze this, am I gonna force it? And I think, because this card is just that important in all these mirrors, that I do think that I'm going to do that. So let's go fetch here to fill our grave, start working our graveyard to get this angler in play. Yes, but like, if they don't, if I don't dismember that, like, Evan, that's a, God, I'm sorry, I can't. Elliot, I can't go there. Like, if this is going to get dazed, I'm going to fight over it, and then it's going to put them back. If I don't do this, then they land a True Name Nemesis, and then when I go to fight with a True Name Nemesis, they daze me. Like, it's difficult to like describe here, but like, I can't fall behind on the tempo, and if my opponent has to set themselves back a turn, so that I don't get True Name Nemesis the turn after. Like, I think that's what I need to work on. And like, the force isn't necessarily like that. Like, the force isn't great, but it might come down to a point of game where I need to force something through or stop what they're doing. And that's what the forces are there for. I don't have all four of them. I just have two. I do think Forces has its spots on the draw on these Delver Raiders. I wouldn't have it on the play, but I am a fan of it on the draw. Wow, they don't have a land. Wow, they just brainstorm lock themselves. Holy shit. Alright, now we're gonna try to see if we can get the pedal to the metal. So they have an Angler, an Edict, a Flusterstorm. Okay. I think I want to fetch a Valk and do this beforehand. Because I don't want to have to fetch another Valk and have them eventually draw a Wasteland and then not have, like if I Ponder and then I want to play Deathrite Shaman, I fetch an Underground Sea and eventually they waste this. It's an unfortunate decision, or unfortunate set of events. It's got them, you know, locked out of the game here. Or not locked yet. I mean, they could, they're two turns away. Okay. Let me get my shaman down. Next time we're gonna get Angler down, I'm not gonna play. Okay, so drawing a Ponder. So I'm not gonna play my Delver because I think I'm just gonna try to ride the Angler and the shuffled. So I think I'm just gonna try to ride the Angler and the Deathrite Shaman for the rest of the game. Okay, so they found the Misty. So this probably is going to get my shaman bolted, if I had to assume what was going on here. I don't think that they can go fetch and play Angler. Yeah. So now I'm in a lot of trouble. Four bolts. Okay. Oh, they have a Flusterstorm. So, if I play my Delver, and they draw land, they just go Bolt Edict, and then I'm up shit creek without a paddle. If they draw land, they go Bolt Edict as well. So I don't think that I want to play 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. I don't think I want to play into them drawing land and just ending the game. So I think I'm going to do is just go like this. Play this. Did he need a Flusterstorm? Yeah, I didn't think about that. I am 3 hours in on the stream, on a stream that started at 4, on a day that started at 4:45 for me, so I'm getting a little tired. Hands out of the play, which they do. So we're in trouble here. Okay. So they have the Flusterstorm, so there's no need letting this go here. Now I'm in a lot of trouble. So they have Flusterstorm, Angler. All right, so I can at least use this casualties to get this Delver off the board. and then I can force the angler. They fluster storm it, and then I eat at the angler. And then we're at. And then we're at parity, except my opponent has a lightning bolt and a draw step. So I'm going to force the angler. They fluster storm it. And now let's hope that they didn't draw a creature to put into play or another counterspell so that we can at least eat it and get the angler off the table. I just gotta hope they don't have another spell here. And I'm probably gonna play my land in order to play around a counterspell. Oh, they had a Delver. That's gross. So we draw a lightning bolt. Last card is bolt. Alright. We're in it. So now I need something like a K command, a pyromancer. I want to hold the pyromancer until I can do something with it, I think. Because they have the lightning bolt. Waste their black source. It is grinding out because I could leverage my force of will to help with my mana situation in order to deal with the Gurmag Angler, and I got lucky to find the Delver. So, like, the force of will played a part in this matchup. Getting back here. They are dazing. Oh, nice. So they're dazing that to get it back. Okay. That's a good play for my opponent. I should have done that in their upkeep. I should have thought about that. That was a good play. These games have been fun tonight. They've all been interactive. They've all had stuff going on. Like, the first two games out of this set here were kind of huge dick-punching fiascos. But this game's been fun. There's been a lot going on. We know they have Lightning Bolt and one other card here. We don't have the other card. Okay, so let's get this. Let's get our Delver out here. Why aren't you playing a Lauren? I don't know. It hasn't piqued my interest. Okay, so that's dead. We knew that was going to happen. All right, now I need a cantrip. Give me something to get this young pyromancer going at least. There she is. So I've got two more, I have one more answer for that. I do like playing. I have fun playing those decks, Nilla. I enjoy playing, you know, good decks. Okay, well, so I'm currently losing this race by a lot. But I could get lucky. I can't even really. I'd have to draw like Deathrite Shaman. So my opponent's gonna be to 8. If I draw like a Lightning Bolt or a Cantrip, something to maybe get going with this young Pyromancer, so I can swing the race my way. Oh, is this an Angler? Oh, that's gross. I wonder if I should just be playing three of, like, more of these and less of the Anglers. Like, is it like a build for three True Nemesis? Alright, well, that's not bad. I guess I should have cast, like, proper mechanics, I should have cast that first. Because like, I can get dazed and then die. Well, I didn't change the deck list. I took the deck lists from different people. Majority. Like, I took this list. Like, both these two lists are from people that play. Yeah, I could actually just... I could steal this one. Alright, I needed to not have a cantrip. Holy shnikey. Attack with one. Block. Block. So if I attack. So I think I wanna put back the force on the bottom, the bolt underneath the force, and just hold the Deathrite Shaman. But I've gotta think. Yeah, I do too. I need to like, but see, if I attack them to 8, and then I go block this, I beat a removal spell, and then next turn I like they go to they're at 8, then I attack them for 6, and then I bolt them. So I think I actually just attack with 1, and then I beat a removal. Then I beat. I guess I'm not beating a lightning bolt because they would just bolt my face. I would beat something like an abrade. I would beat something like Diabolic Edicts the same way. So I can't beat Lightning Bolt. I just wanna like, cause it doesn't matter. I need to, like, out of these two True Name Nemesises, turn to Nemesis, over the two attacks, I need to connect with three of them at least. So I think what I'm going to do is attack with one because I beat a Brain or I beat like K-Command. No, I don't beat K-Command because they just shocked me. The only card that I beat is a Brain that I wouldn't beat by just attacking with both. So I might as well just attack with both. Oh. Because it's the exact same thing. Like attack with one, block, block. They attack. Then untap, attack for two, attack with two of them. I guess they have a counter spell for my lightning bolt. What could they do for a counter spell for my lightning bolt? They get a force plus blue card, which means they need perfects. Flusterstorm. I think it's correct to just attack with Atrium and Nemesis. Put that back, then put that back. Put them to 8, then put them to 2, then kill them. Yep. Get a bolt. Yeah. Yep, couldn't beat a bolt. Yeah, I am up late, Tom. I actually think I'm gonna call it for tonight. So let me move back over here. Let me look at these decks. So I got worked right here. Did very well with this one. So let me get into here. Let me just draw this. Let's go back to the deck. So went 0-3 with this one. But over my last two leagues, I've gone 9-1 with the Stifle list. And I think I like this much better. I like this one much better here. I think it's a little more lower to the ground. There's less air in it. I don't really like Young Pyromancer. Like, I think Pyromancer is kind of like an overrated 2-drop, and I'd rather just play more Gurmags or a Trunane Gnosis. And I'd like to play one more grindy card on my sideboard, but